Hey guys, real quick before we get started, I wanted to thank everybody for all the great comments and feedback that you gave me on all the videos on the dual battery system leading up to this. I also wanted to let everybody know that you should be able to find links to all of the products that we use in the description in the video and also on our website, bradyadventures.com. So enjoy.
Guys, I am totally celebrating because after over a week, I finally have the dual battery system installed in the Land Cruiser. It was quite the project, took quite a bit more effort than I anticipated. Nothing too hard. I am really, really pumped that this thing is done and I am ready to get some accessories in the vehicle. I'm gonna give you guys a walk around of this thing right now. Here's the main battery. It is the PC2150 ST Odyssey. The ST means it has the regular terminals and the threaded terminals. I was a little worried about these. I've showed in another video so you can see a little dent, but it fits okay. In the primary battery location, we use a SLI 31 group upgrade tray. It comes with these mil-spec terminals that have a little extension on it. That's primarily so that you can attach this Land Cruiser fuse link box that's back here. It's also really convenient because it gives you a couple other places to add any of the wiring on each side that you might have. All of our wiring, we use marine grade eyelets, crimped them with a hydraulic crimper and sealed them with shrink wrap. I upgraded the main ground right here that goes to the chassis. I also re-crimped this ground. This line right here is going back to the National Lithium Battery Monitor. Over here we have the Blue Sea terminal fuse block with a single fuse. This is 300 amp. I used a nut to like elevate that off of the battery terminal lug. Coming down from the fuse, we have a single positive wire, and coming off of the negative terminal here we have a single aught negative line, and they're both running together with the National Luna monitor wires. So you can see the cables run right across the back and over to here to the auxiliary battery location, and this is an Odyssey 7586 PC1230 in a SLI auxiliary tray that also has a place for a ARB compressor, either a single or a double. This is also hooked up with a Blue Sea terminal fuse, and there's mil-spec terminals under here. The main hot line comes down over here to the Blue Sea MLACR switch, and then another hot line comes up over to here to a 300 amp fuse on the other side. This side has two fuses, and the second fuse is a 200 amp, and that has a 2-gauge wire. There's a 2-gauge negative, and like I said, this 2-gauge positive. All our wires for the MLACR switch and this National Luna wiring here all run back down through this boot into the rear of the vehicle. Right here, we have the MLACR switch mounted. We had to drill holes in the SLI bracket to get that on there. Right now the switch is engaged, and you can tell by this being pushed in because both batteries are topped up. If I switch this over to off, now they're disconnected. If I go back over here to remote, now it will automatically connect or work with the switch. So over here you can see this is the National Luna battery monitor. So we've got one battery that's in the green and one that's just right at 100%. This is the large PC 2150. This is the auxiliary PC 1230. Here is our switch, our on off auto switch. Right now I think it's blinking because we went from remote to auto. So I think we can just go like that. That might actually reset it. Yep. So now if I click this, you should be able to hear. We're real quiet. Hear it turn on. Hear it connect the two batteries. And when I do that, should even those guys out. And if I disconnect them, it turns the switch off. His voltage will probably drop while we start it. See, just for a second. Now it pops back up because we have the alternator charging. Now, as soon as the switch connects, in probably 15-20 more seconds, this should pop right back up. There it goes and joins the other battery. And then over here you can see we've got the Blue Sea with ground 12 circuit fuse block Got nothing wired up to that right now, but I've got the, except for the ground and the hot. And right here is our circuit breaker, 120 amp for this guy. This is capable of 100 amps, 30 amps per circuit or 100 amps total.
That is it. The next thing that we'll be doing is actually wiring something up to this to provide some power. If you've seen any of our other videos, you'll know that that's going to be a fridge. It's going to mount right up here. So keep an eye out for that. That's going to be coming really, really soon, and it's going to be pretty exciting to actually get something utilizing this system. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. And always feel free to leave us any comments or questions that you might have.